Thank you. Thank you so much. Sorry?
Give me 1 second and I will disturb your show before this button.
Okay. Everybody's sitting comfortably. Tom, a little bit more voice, if you would. Driving through the dead of night, 100 miles on one headlight. At times you can't see what's up ahead, but you make your choice and you make your bed. Moving on. Try to heal the things you've broken, the words you left unspoken. Learn to say goodbye. When the moment's golden, and then choose the hand that opens straight as the crow flies. Moving on. Moving on. With the best of intentions, you can lose the day, but you get back up and on your way, moving on. There's people talking, they tell you lies, and they flap their lips right before your eyes, moving on. To heal the things you've broken, don't leave the words unspoken. Learn to say goodbye and wait for when the moment's golden, and then choose the hand that opens straight as the crow flies. And the dust, you turn the key from hope to trust. And all those hurtful things that were said are in the past now. Look ahead. try to heal the things you've broken, the words you left unspoken. Learn to say goodbye and wait for when the moment's golden, and then choose the path that opens straight as the crow flies, moving on. Moving on. Driving through the dead of night, 100 miles on one headlight. Thank you, thank you. Cheers. Thank you so much. This is the second show that I have played. The other day I got to play a show up in Duncan in the town square as the sun was setting, and it was absolutely sublime. And this is the first indoor club show in God knows how long. Honestly, there's really nothing to say. I mean, there's everything to say, and we could probably spend a long time, but that's not really why we're here. So, but still, I can't, you know, can't not acknowledge that it's very special. I mean, it's really special. I've been doing this, pretty much this exact thing in little dark clubs since I was about 19, 20, somewhere in there. And, this is definitely the longest I've ever gone. As David Gogo said, well, now I know what it's like to retire. It's really, really special to be here and really delightful. So thank you so much for coming. One of the things I've been doing is polishing up on my computer skills, my mixing skills. I got the master tapes from a concert I gave in Holland before everything went pear-shaped. I was doing shows with a band called The Sentimentals, a Danish trio, a Danish-Americana trio, if it can't get any weirder than that, pretty much. We played a show in Eindhoven at a place called Meneer Fritz, which is a lovely dinner club, not unlike this. We multi-tracked the show, and that's what I've been up to over the last couple of months, amongst many other things like biting my nails. I was mixing that show and listening really close and personal to some of these songs and kind of thinking about them in a different way. The song was written after, shortly after, an epic road trip from Saskatoon to Edmonton in January with the ubiquitous mid-size rental and all-season radios. I'm trying to explain to the Dutch audiences just the distances that we are dealing with in North America. Always entertaining. And I remember that night in Eindhoven, I was telling them about 2015 when I moved back to the West Coast. I had been living in Halifax with my wife and daughter, and Mae Moore came to visit us. It's all Mae Moore's fault. May Moore came over from Pender Island to play a show in Halifax. And she was like the embodiment of the West Coast. She showed up for breakfast the morning after her gig with beautiful braided pigtails and this Mother Hubbard nightie on. And she just looked like the embodiment of the West Coast. And after she left, my wife burst into tears and said, "That's it, we're moving." Pretty much. And when your wife says that you're going to move all the way across the country, somewhere in the back of your head, there's a little voice saying, "You will drive the family car." And indeed I did. Four cylinders of raw power. A Hyundai Elantra humming its way across the country. It took me 10 days. And I was telling the Dutch audience that, trying to give them a sense of scale, and I could see this one guy had that, "Oh, I used to have a car like that," look in his eye. Anyway, I explained this song to them, and it's probably the thing I've missed the most over the last year and a half, is just the sheer simple pleasure of getting in a car with your guitar and your pedal board and your CDs, etc., etc., and driving across Canada. A line of crosses in a pie, the wire highway of the telegraph, on a sea of prairie snow, like a picture long ago. And I was riding on the wheel, I was thinking on the past, looking out across the fields, watching people turn to photographs. Every sailor knows the truth of the anchor and the chain. Hold them close to you if you don't want to drift away again. Every gypsy knows the way, like the buttons on his vest and the sun lies down before you out on the big east west. In a silo up ahead, the golden promise of the sun, grind it up into your daily bread, bring it home to your loved one. Once and every now and then, when you get back from the wars, you turn around 'cause you're gone again to that wide open shore. Every sailor knows the truth of the anchor and the chain. Hold them close to you if you don't want to drift away again. Every gypsy knows the way, like the buttons on his vest and the sun lies down before you out on the big east way. Every sailor knows the truth of the anchor and the chain. Hold them close to you if you don't want to drift away again. Every gypsy knows the way, like the buttons on his vest and the sun lies down before you. Out on the Big East West, on the Big East West.
Thank you, thank you. Fun, fun, fun. This may surprise you, but I actually do not do this for the tens of thousands of dollars that you can make. This is something I've been wanting to do and have done since I was pretty small. My mother's just left. She lives in Nelson. She just turned 87, and she was down here for a couple of days for her birthday, and we were reminiscing about old times. And she reminded me that when I was a little kid, little enough to crawl around under the table, I would pretend that I was in a marching band. So clearly this has been something I wanted for a while. And it really is quite lovely to be here, and I will stop talking about it now. Anybody feel like grabbing me a glass of water? I'd sure appreciate that. Thank you. So I want to play songs off of a record that I put out at the very tail end of 2019. And the idea was that I was going to tour it and a new album by Blackie and the Rodeo Kings in 2020. I don't know, I've been listening to, over the last year, listening to musicians talking on, you know, shows like Q, and everybody seems to have the same story, which is 2020 was going to be the fill in the blank, the year when, you know, you put it right over the top. And certainly for me, there was a feeling of holding two new records and all that. Thank you so much. I love the term releasing a record, because in the old days, you used to release a record, and it was kind of like opening the gate, and the Greyhound shot out and ran away down the field. And now releasing a record is kind of like picking it up and hucking it as hard as you can across the room, and that's kind of it. Because, you know, with no retail and Spotify, I don't even want to say that word, the streaming services, which are, yeah, let's not get into that. But, yeah, with retail kind of dead in the water, the idea of releasing an album has kind of turned into this very odd thing where you sort of have an album release every night for about 3 years. And then with COVID, that even got weirder. So I haven't really, it's strange. I've been sitting on a record like a lot of artists for a year and a half, and now I'm kind of playing this album that already feels like it's been out for a year and a half, but it hasn't, because there is no out. It's all in my mind. Anyway, this tune is from that album. The album's called The Unconquerable Past. Surprisingly, there are rather large quantities of that record over here, which I'd love to sell to you later, either in vinyl or CD. But this song is called Someone Else's Shoes, and before I go any farther, I want to acknowledge that we are on the traditional grounds of the Lekwungen people, and given what's going on in Canada, that last song about driving across Canada and Canada itself, which is a country that I personally feel very lucky to be born into, and I love the country very much, but I think we're all starting to take a second look at this country and understand, you know, a lot of stuff has gone down in the name of this country that has been swept under the rug and is now crawling back out from under the rug. So this tune is the idea being that the superpower that we have as human beings, I mean, we're pretty useless, right? We can't run like horses. We can't smell like dogs. Well, some of us smell like dogs, but that's another thing. We can't see like eagles. You know, we're sort of jack of all trades and master of none. But the one thing that we do really, really well is community. And it's actually been the reason why we've, for better or for worse, become what we are, is because our ability to create community is so incredibly well organized, and And we're in danger of losing that. And the one thing that holds us together is empathy. And without empathy, we're fucked. And this song is about that. It's called Someone Else's Shoes. Outside the world is crying, breaks my heart in two. There's no one is an island, better walk in someone else's shoes. 'Cause we don't really see each other, we don't even trust the truth. Is the old divide and conquer, eye for an eye and tooth for tooth. Heaven help the privileged ones who never felt the blues. 'Cause you someone else's shoes, walk in someone else's shoes. Art of drinking water in public.
You laugh, but give it a go sometime.
Because, of course, the chances of spilling it all over yourself and your guitar are pretty large. So, next song I want to play you is also from that album, which is called The Unconquerable Past, and I will get into, I have to remember to speak onto this because I know that you guys can hear me, but we're streaming. God love us, we're streaming for the rest of my life, streaming. We all should have bought shares in plexiglass and Zoom, shouldn't we? The Unconquerable Past is kind of a strange title. I'll explain it later. But here's another song from that album. With a title like that, you'd sort of be right in guessing that I am dwelling a lot on the idea of time. And as I approach the age of 60, I think I'm right on track for that kind of thinking. Nostalgia, sort of. This is called Gold on the River. Well, I ran so fast for years, I thought the price was tears and running was the key. I look for love and comfort everywhere. I learned to stare, but I never learned to see. And I was playing some casino, and there you were, beside the spinning wheel of fortune, my rhinestone girl. When I was young and innocent, I mostly felt just awkward and naive.
And I wanted to be older, with my coat slung on my shoulder, my heart on my sleeve. And when I finally found the stillness in myself, I started wondering just how many years were left upon the shelf. Time paints a lullaby with gold on the river till the rivers run dry. Time is a long goodbye. It's a taker and a giver. It's a slow dance, and we all want more time. We made love among the ruins. We made music out of all that history. We found joy as the summer waned and winter blew the leaves off of the trees. And we measured all the sweetness that we found against the bitter times of waiting till the good times come around. Time paints a lullaby with gold on the river till the rivers run dry. Time is a long goodbye. It's a taker and a giver. It's a slow dance, but we all want. Is a peaceful Sunday morning cup of tea. Is my shelter from the storm when I know the storm is waiting for me. And when I'm far away and down to the bone, trying to sing my way to heaven, trying to get back home. It's a lullaby with gold on the river till the rivers run dry. Time is a long goodbye. It's a taker and a giver. It's a slow dance, and we all want.
Thank you. There's a line in that song about meeting my rhinestone girl at a casino. And that's actually a true story. Most everything else is just complete bullshit, but that's really true. When I was very young, I made the leap from Enid Blyton to Ian Fleming in a very short order. So I sort of went from like the Famous Five and the Secret Seven to Casino Royale and Thunderball and all those great, The Man with the Golden Gun. I loved those books when I was young. And I had this very warped idea of what casinos were from reading those books. I thought they were places of wealth and taste and sophistication. And words like Monte Carlo came to mind. So the first casino that I ever went to was in Prince George. And it was disappointing, I gotta say. I was on tour with Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, and of course, and I decided I would go in and had $20 to spend. And it left my hand in about a minute and a half. And I spent the rest of the time watching, drinking flat Coca-Cola and watching Tom Wilson lose money. That was really fun. But suffice to say that I sort of learned my lesson early, which is probably a good thing. And the only time I've ever been to casino since is when they hire me to play music. And it's a sort of dodge to get hapless punters in the door by providing a free concert. And then the hopes are that you'll have a few drinks and then, you know, head over to the crap table and lose your mortgage. And so we are the bait that kind of gets you in the door. It's great being in the music business, I tell you. Anyway, I was at the Halifax Casino with Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, and I met my wife. And she, that was pretty much it for me. Even though I had sworn off things like the word marriage and the like, it all pretty much changed in a heartbeat, as it often does. Her name is Christine, and Christine is a great rock and roll name because it has the right amount of vowels and consonants. And it rhymes with queen and gasoline, and that's all you need. Christine, my rodeo queen. Christine, my rodeo queen. She got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. I was sleeping on the couch, I was eating humble pie, until I learned to see the things she's saying with her eye. Christine, my rodeo queen. She got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. Like a tea bag, you throw her in the pot, but you never know how strong she gets until the water's hot. Christine, I'm a rodeo queen. She got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. See my coffee, I tell you why, enough caffeine to make a dead man fly. I think about the gals that I knew before they got the real fireworks start the Third World War. Christine, got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. Tell you why, enough caffeine to make a dead man fly. I think about the gals that I knew before they got the real fireworks start the Third World War. Christine, Christine, Christine. Mm-hmm. She got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. She loved me like a river, she loved me like the rain. I was dying in the desert like a dog on a chain. Christine, Christine. She got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. She got a heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline. A heart full of soul, a soul full of gasoline.
Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to leave the unconquerable past for a little bit and go back to another record. This is a song called Red Lights in the Rain. The Dutch were saying that it had a kind of a different meaning. Over there.
It's alchemy in motion on the highway. those headlights making diamonds out of rain. And the feeling that you don't know where you're going, when you know for sure exactly where you've been. We held on to the dream, the four-leaf clover. Everybody's gonna set the world on fire. And the little voice that whispers when it's over, you can't escape yourself when it comes down to the wire. Nothing says I'm hungry like a baby. No one says I'm lonely like a train. We never said goodbye, we never even tried, and nothing says I'm gone like red lights in the rain. And it seems like my whole life has been an emotion. I learned to pack a suitcase as a child, and I'm always drawn to sit beside the ocean with the water and the wind and the tide. Ah, but I'm weary of living like a sailor, drifting with the current in my veins. A man gets to feeling like a failure. He's looking for a place to drop the anchor once again. Nothing says I'm hungry like a baby. No one says I'm lonely like a train. We never said goodbye, we never even tried, and nothing says I'm. Like red lights in the rain. I'm hungry like a baby. No one says I'm lonely like a train. We never said goodbye, we never even tried, and nothing says I'm. Like red lights in the rain. Red lights in the rain.
Thank you. I'm going to go way back now to an older record. I was telling you my ma was visiting. My ma married an Irishman when I was 6 years old. And so we moved to Ireland. I was born in Vancouver, but we moved to Ireland. I grew up in Ireland. And so after I left, anytime I toured through England or the UK or anywhere nearby, of course, I'd go to Ireland and spend a couple of weeks or whatever time I had at the beginning or end of a tour visiting. And there's something about when you've left home and you go back to your old childhood bedroom that is kind of precious and really weird. My bedroom was up in the attic, and so when I left, it kind of just, they just sort of closed the door, and nobody really went up there too much. And so my sisters referred to it as the shrine. And there was all that stuff from, you know, when I was in high school, like the pot plant leaf that my friend Stuart drew, and all that stuff. It was still there. And so I would go and stay there for a couple of nights, and it was just always kind of strange. I had weird dreams. And this one particular tour, I started it by going straight to Dublin and spending a couple of days there, so I was jet-lagged. And I woke up in the middle of the night, and I just had this really weird dream that my wife at the time, my then-wife, was pregnant. And when you're a songwriter, you'll grab at anything to sort of get a song out of it. It's sort of part of the deal. So beware if you have friends who are songwriters. When they tell you that the song's not about you, they're lying. It is about you. And so you hear conversations on the bus, dreams, whatever it is, it's all game. It's all grist for the mill, and it goes in the notebook. And when I was writing this dream down at my mother's place up in the attic there, and I remember thinking, maybe this is too far. Maybe this is too personal, and I should not write about this. And obviously, I did, because here it is in this song. It's called The Man Who Married Music. I had a dream that you were pregnant. I woke to pray that the stork who carries baby songs was headed my way. I was tangled in the sheets. I was torn between the two. The man who married music and the man who married you. Am I over the hill? Have I gone around the bend? 'Cause I'm out there chasing songs and melodies that never end. And I sing them 'cause I have to. But I love them, so I do. The man who married music and the man who married you. Every life is suffering. Every life is pain. Agony and ecstasy are my middle names. And truth is stranger than fiction. Strange is what I do. So keep a candle in the window, and I'll be home soon. You're not the jealous kind, 'cause on the day we were wed, there were two grooms and two brides, and I stood right beside you. They stood beside us too. The man who married music and the man who married you.
I miss you when I'm everywhere. I miss you when I'm home. I miss you when I'm nothing, when I'm alone. And truth is stranger than fiction. Strange is what I do. The man who married music and the man who married you. The man who married music and the man who married you.
All right. One more song, then we take a break, and you can get up and walk around, get a drink. Yeah, I'm getting there. You know it. I'm just trying to decide how to pitch this now. It's the first pitch in a year and a half, really. I know. You're looking at the vinyl, and you're thinking, but Stephen, we all got rid of our record players 25 years ago. Okay, well, some of you didn't because some of you are smart. I personally got rid of my record player 20-something years ago, and then I lugged around a milk crate, two of them full of LPs that I was never going to play, but I couldn't let them go. And then finally I got a turntable, and I thought, what the fuck was I waiting for? Because the pleasure of going to Ditch Records, or you can buy them at London Drugs now. I mean, hello, vinyl is like officially, seriously back. The pleasure of flipping through and looking at them and that smell in the old vinyl stores and the whole sound of the needle dropping and the runoff groove, all of that stuff. If you haven't done it in a long time, get thee hence to Value Village. Don't get all caught up in hi-fi stuff. Like, just go get an old used turntable. Q Electronics has a great selection of weird old gear. And honestly, you can set yourself up for not that very much money at all. And you can go back to that place. There's only a few things that you can do in your life where you get to go back home. And vinyl is one of them. So do it. Just do it. And then you can buy both of my records. And if you're thinking, no, Stephen, we just, you know what, we crossed that bridge and we're never going back. You can still buy my records because your children have gone back. So you can buy it for them, and then you can get, there's some of them have the digital download, so you can listen to it on your car, on your phone, or through, you know, little tiny earbuds that sound like mosquitoes in your head. If you want to listen to it that way, you can. But please, don't hesitate. Don't let fear hold you back. Let your conscience be your guide. And of course, I have CDs as well. I know you've heard that the CD is dead. The CD is not dead. It is alive and well and right there on that piano, just dying to go home with you. So, is that enough? I can go more. I have all these different sort of crossroads I can go to. Yes, that's enough. Yeah. Well, actually, that dovetails quite nicely with this song, the idea of reading glasses. I called them reading glasses for a long, long time. I was like, I was the Costco guy. I had, you know, the 12-pack Costco reading glasses. They were scattered all over the place because I could never remember to bring them with me because they were just reading glasses, right? And then one day, actually one morning, about 4 a.m., I was in a hotel, and I had an early morning wake-up call because I had an early flight. And I stood in front of the mirror underneath that horrible LED light, and I looked at myself, and I couldn't see my face properly. Not because of, you know, some crazy rock and roll debauchery the night before, but because I am over 50. It was all blurred. It was early in the morning and my eyes hadn't quite woken up yet, so I went and got my reading glasses. And I put them on and then I could see myself in 1.75 clarity. And it was sobering. And I realized I had this epiphany, which I figured that my demographic could relate to. And the epiphany was that the shittier my eyesight gets, the better I see myself. So now I wear my reading glasses when I decide to shave. I see myself much better now than in my younger days. Some people are obsessed with time and rains on the parade. Ah, but time is just a silver thread woven through these golden days. I used to know a woman. She proclaimed that she loved her man. I said, no, you love the idea more, but she didn't understand. She imagined love like a velvet glove that takes all the pain away. But love is just a silver thread woven through these golden days. These golden days are all we have between the cracks of now and then. Every hero and every villain has a beginning and an end. Light a fire, take your preconceptions and throw them onto the blaze. You got nothing but your birthdays in these golden days. I met a genuine celebrity. His ambition was his jail. Every day he locked himself inside a fantastic fairy tale. He thought of fame like a black limousine headed out to the last hooray. But fame is just a silver thread woven through these golden days. A gambler and a priest were playing stud one rainy day. Gambler bet with his heart and his soul, and the priest counted cards like faith. He raised his eyes to heaven, saw the gambler raise the stakes, saying faith is just a silver thread woven through these golden days. These golden days are all we have between the cracks of now and then. Every king and every joker has a beginning and an end. Take your preconceptions and throw them under the blaze. You got nothing but your birthday suit in these golden days. So when the song is over and the last chord shimmers and dies, I drive away through darkened streets lit by stars and moonlight to lay me down on the strange sheets of all the grand plans that I made. And I turn my face toward the dawn and another golden day. As the future lies before us, as the past slips clean away, all the fast roads and the back roads stretch between the hurricanes. The things we wish we'd never done and the love we hoped would stay. Our regret is just a silver thread woven through these golden days. These golden days are all we have between the cracks of now and then. Every star and wannabe has a beginning and an end. Light a fire with all your preconceptions and throw them onto the blaze. You got nothing but your birthday suit now in these golden days. Light a fire, take your preconceptions and throw them onto the blaze. You got nothing but your birthday suit in these golden days. Have a good break. I'll see you in a bit.
Well, this is the newest one. It's the one I'm playing about this. Awesome. Yeah, I just love that guitar. So, Yeah.
Yeah, whichever one you. I basically got this too. I got the third one, but these are all in order now. Or your middle, newer.
Okay.
So this one's like 20.
What do you like?
Which one? You know what? The newest one's all the favorites. $20.
What's that? Yeah, take your time. Well, we truly are in the in-between times, aren't we? Masks, no masks. It's weird to have just met you all with a mask on and now be up here without one. Yeah, it was profitable. I've been breaking for quite some time, so I'm happy to stop breaking right now. Do you love your children? Do you treat them right? Kiss them good morning, kiss them good night. I love that girl, I give her everything I have. And I never have enough, but she gets everything I am. Do you love your woman? Do you treat her right? Hold her in your arms, look her in the eye. Siren crows on the morning, somewhere in a city all alone. Hear that lonesome whistle in your heart, tells you all you need to know. And when you hear that voice calling, everybody knows, knows they went ahead of you, are singing you back home. You turn around. In your heart tells you all.
but who knows? Those that went ahead of you are singing you back home. You turn around. It takes everything you have, and you never have enough. But you give everything you can, and I never have enough. I give everything, everything.
Thank you. So that's a song from Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, an album called South, which came out a long time ago. And last year was Blackie and the Rodeo Kings' 25th anniversary, which is kind of wild. I have a picture of us on our very first tour. We were touring across Canada. We just released High or Hurtin', the songs of Willie P. Bennett. And we were touring across Canada in this old 45-foot Eagle tour bus, which was on its last legs. And it was just Colin and myself and Tom. We were a trio. And our driver, Kev Cassidy, he would do anything. He was a fearless man. He pulled a U-turn in a 45-foot Eagle in Chinatown because Colin wanted Chinese food. But the front of the bus, it was so old that it had that roll thing where you could change the name of who was in the bus. And when we discovered that, we started going through it, and Johnny Cash was on the list. Jimmy Buffett was on the list. This was the tour bus that Randy Rhodes, who played guitar for Ozzy Osbourne for years, he died by buzzing this bus in a plane on a tour. So he went up, he had a pilot's license, and buzzed this bus and hit the bus. And Randy didn't make it. But they repaired the bus and put it back on the road, and we had it. And so we got black electrical tape, and we put Willie P. Bennett in a blank space, and we had that on the front. We went through a Tim Hortons drive-through on that bus as Johnny Cash. And when we got to the window, there were about 15 people crowded in the window. It's like, Johnny Cash is ordering Timbits and coffee. So they said, is Johnny there? And Tom kind of came around the corner of the window and said, ah, he's in the back. We were Jimmy Buffett going into Cranbrook, and a woman came up to us in Cranbrook and told us the story of how her child had been hit in the head with an axe, and Jimmy Buffett's music had pulled the kid through. People tell you the damnedest things. Like, I was like, wait, go back to the bit about hit in the head with an axe? What? And then when we went to Banff, we played the Banff Center, and we wanted to get into, it was getting late, and we knew that the bar wouldn't let us in. So we were Earth, Wind, and Fire. This is all in the front of the bus. You just scroll through. It's like, yeah, try Earth, Wind, and Fire. So we were Earth, Wind, and Fire. We pulled up to this pub, and the bouncer looked at the bus and said, okay, yeah, you can come in for a quick drink. So we're going in. We're all white, like really white. And my friend Georgina, who's also really white, was with us. And as she passed the bouncer, who's kind of looking at us as we go by, like, and she goes by and she says, I'm wind. He knew he'd been had. I don't know why I'm telling you this story. I have no idea why I'm telling you this story. Blackie and the Rodeo Kings, 25th anniversary. Yeah, the whole point of the story is gone. It doesn't really matter. This is a song from an album we made years ago called Kings and Queens. And Kings and Queens, the premise of it was that Blackie and the Rodeo Kings is a very weird band because we formed to celebrate the music of Willie P. Bennett, our patron saint and brother and mentor to all of us in all of our different musical lives. And we got together to celebrate his music and to make this tribute record 25 years, well, now 26 years ago. And what was supposed to be a one-off record ended up being this, I don't know, this other... Career is not the right word. It's like a family. We really are a family after 25 years of being together and all of that touring and all that crazy times being Earth, Wind, and Fire, etc. And anyway, we've made a bunch of records. This is a song called Black Sheep. So we made this album called Kings and Queens. And given that we're at the very least of the things we are is a collaboration. The folk guy, Colin Linden, the blues guy, Tom Wilson, the rock guy. Like, that's sort of how we were perceived when we started. And so the whole point is to collaborate. And we collaborated to start it around the music of Willie P. Bennett, and it went on from there. And so we thought we'd make a record where we collaborate as a band with female artists, the likes of Emmylou Harrison, Roseanne Cash, Lucinda Williams, Cassandra Wilson, like a seriously incredible lineup of players. And this tune is a song I brought to the table. The queen on this was Serena Ryder, who has an amazing voice. She's got a really wide range. And this tune's called Black Sheep. He said, baby, I'm done, and he pushed back his plate. The sky was as dark as the hour was late. I took the fight with the lean and the hot with the cold. But I'm hungry for love. I'll go down by the river where the silver moon shines. I'll read my reflection like the book of my mind. I've been dreaming of rainbows and rumors of gold. I've been dreaming of love. Hold to what's broken the rest of your day. I'll let go of the vow to have and to hold. I went to my neighbor to show him my heart. Start, 'cause there's friends of the heart and there's friends of the road in the passing of love. Love in the passing of love. Love in the passing of love. I don't know what you think, what you say, all the tales that I spun at the end of the day. Walk a mile in my shoes, a life in my soul. Thank you.
and the woods are alive with the murmur of spring. Snow melts away and the creeks start to sing. When the shepherd's asleep, the black sheep leaves the fold, gone looking for love, love, looking for love. Looking for
back to the unconquerable past. Some of these songs, some of them come from guitar riffs, snatches of conversation. The title cut, The Unconquerable Past, came from a book, and it was a quote. But this song, Marie, it really just came from the name. I imagined this person, and I was having a conversation with them, and that's how the whole song started. She said, brace yourself for the shit show coming down tomorrow. Cause I believe it's all gonna look a whole lot different than it does today. Remember all that time we begged and we stole and we borrowed. Well, the fix is in and the piper's getting paid. And fuck those greedy liars, midnight riders with the power and the glory. The tinfoil hat religion and the dark conspiracies. The brown shirts are back and the boys are hanging out with the planet floating out to sea. All the tears that we've cried, all the sorrow and the need. Hold on to my hand, don't let go of it, don't let go of me, Marie. How strange we are, how magnificently broken. You know, even a busted clock can tell the time twice a day. But even if every one of us was lying there overcome,
Well, I wonder, would we argue the last gasp of this precious life away? All the tears that we've cried, all the sorrow and the need, hold on to my hand, don't let go of it, don't let go of it.
Thank you, thank you. So I'll play the title cut. There was this guy who sort of had his heyday in the 50s and 60s, maybe early 70s. His name was Oscar Levant, and I only know this because I researched him. And he shows up in this weird way in a book that Patrick DeWitt, the great author Patrick DeWitt, wrote, The Sisters Brothers. He also wrote a great book called The French Exit, which has just been made into a movie. And I was reading that book in 2019 at a friend's flat in James Bay and writing songs for this record. And I, at the start of every chapter, had a quote. And this one chapter starts with this quote by Oscar Levant. And the quote is, ah, the unconquerable past. And who knows what it is that, you know, rings the bell for you. But for me, I was intrigued by that statement. And it just got me thinking. And as I said, you know, I'm hitting 60 and I'm thinking back and I'm looking at things and the unconquerable past. The unconquerable past. Put a hole in your future like a smithereen of glass, like a memory beneath the sutures. And the older we become, brave in all the slings and arrows, on the road to kingdom come, nobody can outrun the unconquerable. Unimpeachable truth, or is it just how we remember? 'Cause our plan was foolproof, and we all could have been contenders. Just the beginning of the end, or just the end of the beginning. If there's something you regret, forgive but don't forget the unconquerable past. The unconquerable past. Cross the valley from the future. And we drove that road so fast till the wheels came off our adventure. And we finally come to rest in some quiet part of nowhere, out of time and out of gas, like coming home at last to the unconquerable. Past.
Is it all just too much for you? Does anything make sense? Or does everything just bore you? Has it all been done before? All the successes and the failure. Friend, take it on the chin and learn to start again with the unconquerable past. The unconquerable past. Cross the valley from the future. We drove that road so fast till the wheels came off our adventure. And we finally come to rest in some quiet part of nowhere. Out of time and out of gas, like coming home at last to the unconquerable. Thank you, thank you.
Okay, another song from The Unconquerable Past. This one again, it was another, this seems to be an album for people's names. So this one is called Sunny, but I couldn't tell, I didn't know if Sunny was male or female, because you know Sunny's Dream, that great Ron Hines song. Sonny, don't go away. Sonny's male in that one. And then there's Sonny, one so true, I love you. So Sonny could be either way. And since, of course, you have to sort of define it when you spell it, but since I'm singing it, I figured I could maybe walk right down the middle.
Sonny came down to the city. Getting gone was the only way she knew. Far from the whispers and the rumors, what else was a small town kid to do? Found a place out on the east side, just a room at the Sugarland Motel. You could call it lost if you wanted. Sonny called to trying to find yourself. Sonny's dad was one hard ticket. Mother was a hard ticket's wife. Spent most of her days keeping her head down and getting on with her hard ticket life. And she said, Sonny, just as long as I can remember, you were born a mystery to me. A little boy standing on the corner of who you are and who you want to be. Here I got some money I've been saving. Take it now before I change my mind. Take it now for every year I've been slaving. Might help to pay for the life you hope to find. Mm-hmm. veil of truth is a thorny ramble. You gotta walk that lonesome road all by yourself. And heaven help the desperate soul who gambles on living their whole life as someone else. Me and Sonny been together since the autumn, and now we take each season one day at a time. 'Cause I believe that you smoke 'em if you got 'em. Yeah, you live the life that makes you whole inside. You live the life that makes you whole inside.
Thank you. Gone behind us, walk me home, walk me home. Well, I'm crazy. If you dream it, you can find it. Walk me home, walk me home. Wild and brave, I think it makes us wiser. Walk me home. Torn and frayed, no shame, no compromise. Walk me home, see it in my eyes. From the bottom of the well, cold blue water ringing like a bell. Walk me home, see it in my eyes. A love like water, bigger than the blue sky, bigger than the sky.
Speed.
Every soul's a sailor rolling on the deep. The tinker and the tailor, the beggar and the thief. The winners and the failures, the shepherd and the sheep. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the deep. Born into creation, drawn toward the light, with blind imagination, we go swimming in the night. And the guiding star of fate shines for our mortality. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the sea. Read the cards and weep. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the deep. I drove into the mountains. I left the world behind. A singer on a mission with a half a case of wine. And I stared into the night sky, pure infinity. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the sea. I'll look before you leap. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the cards and weep. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the deep. Every soul's a sailor rolling on the
Thanks, Tom, for doing sound. Thank you so much. Thank you for coming. Hopefully this is the start of something great. Been doing nothing for the last year and a half. I can play a couple more songs. You know, the last time I played here, aside from that Songwriters in the Round thing that I did a year ago, but before that, it was with Andy White, my buddy Andy White. And Andy lives in Australia, And so every tour that we did started with a flight from Australia. It kind of killed the duo sort of in the water. It was hard for us to actually make a profit. So we don't tour anymore, but we're still very fond of each other. And a lot of the songs that we wrote were written around the idea of a duo, so very much interweaving parts and sort of two voices all the time. And it kind of makes it very difficult to play any of those songs because I just feel a lack of Andy when I play them. But there's one song that we wrote together when I was living out in Halifax. And Andy and I both grew up in Ireland. He was actually born in Belfast. I was born in West Van, but I moved to Ireland when I was 6 and a half, somewhere in there. And I lived in Dublin until I was 17, so very formative years. So we had this, when we met each other years ago at the Winnipeg Folk Fest, we had this instant connection. We're same age, grew up on either side of that border, and both sort of singer-songwriters, solo guys. Anyway, Andy came to stay with me in Halifax, and I said, I want to write this song. Hear me out, because I knew he'd be like, oh, no, roll his eyes, because I said, I want to write a song that starts with the words, fare thee well. I wanted to start with this traditional song idea, but kind of take a left turn from there. So we ended up writing this tune together, and it's a nice way to end the night.
Fare thee well, my one and only. I am traveling overseas. For my country, it doesn't want me. And my faith is on its knees. I will follow every highway, through the street lights and the chrome, and find a city where someone needs me and a place to call my own. On Sunday night, I was in Dublin, was the last day. Walking through a concrete wasteland, all that ancient hope and fear. There was nothing left to reach for, to pull myself out of the fray. I got my ticket now, and I am leaving. So don't watch me walk away. Fare thee homeland, I always loved you from the first. Fare thee well, beautiful country, even when you're at your worst. When the rain falls in Vancouver, something makes me look away. Like every immigrant, I still love you, and that is why I cannot stay. When the rain falls in Vancouver, something makes me look away. Like every immigrant, I still love you, and that is why I cannot stay. like every immigrant, I still love you, and that is why I cannot stay. There's a piece of my heart no country can claim. All I have in this world is my word and my name. But if I am so lucky to see you again, oh, well, I'll be a fortunate one. There's a place in my mind and it never forgets. That forgiveness, it might just be all that we get. If there's peace in this world, I ain't found it yet. Ah, but still I'm a fortunate one. Bring us your tired, your hungry, and your poor. 'Cause if this isn't privilege, then what's it all for? When I stumble, heaven forbid I forget that I am a fortunate one. There's a piece of my heart no country can claim. All I have in this world is my word and my name.
Thank you so much. Don't forget to tip the waitress.